यह है एक इंडियन स्टार्टअप का ड्रोन मोटर जो लिटरली देश के लोहे से बना है और मैं आपको सब कुछ दिखाऊंगा राइट फ्रॉम मतलब मेटल के वो शीट से उसको कट करने से लेके मोटर का इंटरनल बनाना, उसे वाइंड करना कॉपर वायर के साथ, पूरी असेंबली करना, कुछ बोनस स्टफ जैसे कार्बन प्रोपेलर्स और उनके कुछ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, हम सब कुछ देखेंगे। ये है एक रेयर एक्सक्लूसिव लुक एट वेक्टर टेक्निक्स। इस वीडियो में हमें जो फैक्ट्री टूर करवाएंगे वो है पृथ्वी, जो है को फाउंडर वेक्टर टेक्निक्स के। इन्होंने मुझे एक मोटर भी दिया जिसके ऊपर गरीब साइंटिस्ट एनग्रेव्ड है और मैंने उसे खोल के सेपरेट कर दिया। इसी कारण मैं आपको एक क्विक 30 सेकंड एक्सप्लेनेशन दे देता हूँ कि ये काम कैसे करता है। देखो, इस मोटर के दो पार्ट है, लेफ्ट में स्टेटर, राइट में रोटर। इसके नाम से शायद आपको पता चल गया होगा, स्टेटर जो है वो है स्टेशनरी, उसी से उसका नाम आता है, क्योंकि इसके नीचे स्क्रू होते हैं जो फ्रेम में चले जाएंगे। इसके बीच में बॉल बेयरिंग जिसके अराउंड वो आयरन कोर है जिसपे कॉपर वाइंडिंग जाते हैं, इससे करंट फ्लो होता है, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जनरेट होता है। इसके आयरन कोर को ढंग से देखो, आपको लाइंस दिखेंगे साइड में, इसका एक रीजन है जो आपको आगे पता चलेगा। ये फील्ड्स जो है मैग्नेटिक फील्ड्स इंटरैक्ट करेंगे रोटर के मैग्नेट के साथ। तो अगर रोटर के अंदर दिखाऊं, रोटर मतलब रोटेटिंग पार्ट इस मोटर का, तो आपके काफी सारे मैग्नेट दिखेंगे जो उसके अराउंड लगे। उस रोटर के बीच में सेंटर शाफ्ट है जो उस स्टेटर के बीच में चला जाता है बिल्कुल। और आप देखो यहाँ पे कोई भी कॉन्टेक्ट टाइप नहीं है, लाइक ब्रश या कोई वायर नहीं है, इसलिए ये एक ब्रशलेस डीसी मोटर, या आपने इंडस्ट्री टर्म सुना होगा BLDC मोटर। तो अभी टूर शुरू करते हैं। आप सिंस हिंदी पे हो तो आप सबटाइटल्स ऑन करो हिंदी के बेटर समझने के लिए।
देयर आर टू एलिमेंट्स इन अ मोटर, वन इज अ स्टेटर एंड वन इज अ रोटर।
हां,
वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम देम। सो आवर कांसेप्ट इज मेटल टू मोटर।
हां, राइट।
सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद द स्टेटर। यू सी दिस इज द स्टील दैट वी गेट, गॉट इट आउट फॉर यू। सो दिस इज कॉल्ड अ CRNGO सिलिकॉन स्टील, और दे इन सम एरियाज दे कॉल इट अ जापानीज स्टील आल्सो।
Okay.
So, this is a 0.2 mm steel. In few very pro motors, we use 0.15 mm also.
Okay.
So, the steel comes in rolls like this. Okay. So, and we cut it into slits.
Mm-hmm.
If we want to do R&D. If we don't want to do R&D, like this one, we feed it into a machine called punching machine or stamping machine.
Okay.
So, different areas call it in a different way. So, it's called progressive stamping. So, what it does, it cuts. If you see, this is progression. So, from small hole to big hole, then it cuts the actual stator.
Oh, okay.
So, that's called progressive tooling. Once this is cut, the element what we get, I'll show you in the next step, is called a laminate of a stator. So, we bond or notch all the laminates to become a stator. That is the stator part.
Okay.
For the rotor part, we use aluminum mainly on the top. So, this is, we get it from Jindal and Hindalco. Everything is sourced in India. So, this is, again, we have a couple of grades. But most of our UAV motors we use 7075.
Okay.
Okay. So the other part is called a ring. So this is a magnetic ring where you will actually paste magnets later. So, and this is also mild steel. On top of it, we do a vapor deposition coating. So this becomes a motor, but I'll start with the stator.
Sure.
So if you observe that there is a punch, that punch becomes this.
Yeah.
Okay. So on this machine, so we have a, the stator, if you see the configuration of a stator, they usually call it 80-20, 60-15, 60-20 is nothing. It's a 60 mm diameter. And if we stack up 15 millimeters, it becomes 60-15.
Okay.
So we align them, stack them up. Once the weight, everything is correct as per the quality, then we actually make a stator. Something like, so we bond all of them. So the same laminate, you can't even figure out that it looks like a full block.
I also think it's the whole thing is CNC'd or something.
No, it's not. So all of them we bond based on the height of the stator that we want. So this also, because we do them instead of notching or laser welding, we do bonding of laminate to laminate. So it's more efficient than a regular motor.
Okay. Okay.
So after that is completed, we have our own in-house powder coating processes. We do powder coating. Why we do powder coating is, this is an insulation material. On top of this, if you do winding on a bare metal, it shorts. So this layer of coating prevents it from shorting. So that is the isolation material.
Okay.
So once this is all complete, there's a lot of curing process. This is an 8-hour process. Then it goes into the winding machine. You can come. Start it. So this is our automatic winding machine. So this, we'll start a new batch now for you to see. but after winding, this is how it becomes.
Okay.
So that's how the stator is made. So there are different sizes of stators that we make. This is what you call as 4006.
What does it mean?
4006 is a 40mm stator, 6mm stack height.
Okay.
So most of the surveillance category of drones currently use 4006 380 kV. This is the current batch production that we are doing. So, and we do a lot of R&D. This is for a fixed wing VTOL. This is 6008, not launched yet. We are launching next month. So after the winding, then we have a very strict QA/QC process where we do checking of multiple parameters of winding, whether the coating is correct, whether the face-to-face difference is correct, and then we will identify which face is what, and then whether the enamel is correct or there any damage in the enamel. Once everything is complete, we do a Kevlar threading. Why we do a Kevlar threading is, in high speeds, the copper tends to come out of these grooves. So this Kevlar threading will prevent it to come out of the grooves.
Okay, wait, but this is the stator, right?
Yes.
So this is stationary?
No, this, in outrunner motors, even though it is the same, the armature rotor actually rotates. Okay. The stator stays the same. So even if this is staying the same, because of expansion, the magnetism have north-south commutation, this tends to come out.
Okay. This you know after years of building.
So for rapid prototyping, we will skip that process of stamping because it's a very huge, intensive, heavy industry process. We do wire cutting. You can come around like this. So if you see the program, currently we are doing a stator wire cutting. This is a very slow process, but we do it for limited batch production or some R&D production. This is a 150mm stator. So that is the wire cut. So we bond the laminates first, then we do a wire cut. So if you see, there's a point to point laminate, all bonded together, then it's cut. So it becomes a stator. It's currently in process. This is for a 100 kilogram weight motor.
Oh wow, okay.
Then it comes into the stator part, the 4006, whatever you saw there. Now we press the hub. This is called the hub of the stator. So the winding part comes here from that stations and we insert this along with the bearings.
Oh.
So this now this becomes the stator part of the actual motor, full complete stator. Then we also make, so that's the part without assembly. This is prior to assembly.
Okay.
So this part that goes inside.
So this is injection molded and...
No, this is all aluminum.
This is
7075 aerospace grade aluminum.
Okay.
And it's anodized.
Wow.
So once that is done, that becomes single part. Again, it's work in progress.
This is such a huge job.
So what we did is we have more than the motor, we innovated a lot in the machinery around it. So this station is magnet inserting or stapling station, we call it. So we made it ourselves as a concept. She is doing one inserting process right now. So one by one, it's North Pole, that's South Pole. We insert magnets into the ring. Get me one ring there. So once this is done, once we have figured out this whole process to be efficient, so we made a full machine, fully automated for it. So this takes about 15 minutes per stator. That takes about 1.5 minutes per rotor. Yeah. So while inserting the magnets, after inserting, this is how it will look.
Wow.
And the top is also pressed. So for the pressing the top, again, that station goes there. So it's a precision pressing station that we have. Multiple stations for multiple motors. So once that is made, everything is aligned. But prior to aligning, what we are currently doing is we are doing a dynamic balancing of the rotor. Because it's a fast rotating element. Similar to wheel balancing, we do balancing of the rotor. So there will be added material to ensure there is no vibration when it's spinning faster. So that balancing is done. Once the balancing is done, full motor is done.
Okay.
So in the process, we have a lot of work in progress material. There's a lot of in process material. Then there is a lot of QAQC material. So different. That's a 40 series bay, 60 series, 80 series, 150 series. So we have multiple range of motors.
What does this series mean?
Series is the outer diameter of the motor.
Motors. Okay, I thought also.
So this is 80 series. For example, it's just 80mm motor.
Okay.
80mm stator.
Okay.
So in this again, we have various classes. If it's open type, which needs a lot of ventilation, and lighter weight, we call it SL. It's super light. It's internal way of talking about motors. When it's closed, we call it prototype, which is professional motors.
So how many SKUs, I don't know, that's in the
system. We have a lot of SKUs.
So you make per requirement?
Based on requirement. Now we have a batch production of 60mm motors getting balanced. So once that is done, we do laser engraving of serial batching. So this is PDB, not motor, but we do a laser engraving of serial numbers so that people don't tamper with it.
Wait, do you all make this as well?
These are our own propellers. These are 30-inch propellers.
Wait, so not just motors. Okay, this is new to me.
We make propellers, we make ACs also. This is a 30-inch propeller called carbon fiber reinforced polymer, CFRP.
Oh.
So we have different sizes on it. This is a 30-inch 12 pitch. This is for high altitude.
This is 23.
This right?
Yeah, you can put it there. This is a 23-inch propeller. Again, these are design.
This is what material you said? Carbon?
Carbon fiber reinforced polymer.
Okay, it's still injection mold.
This is injection mold.
Okay. Wow. These are so nice.
Then we have multiple different propellers. This is a 30-inch 10-pitch propeller. Again, we have a custom profile for high speed but low audible noise sort of a thing. I mean, we have a lot of balancing stations and rest of it.
Wow, there's so much.
Yeah.
But this is not what I expected.
So this is how a batch production looks. 40mm motors.
Wow, this is hardware pawn.
Yeah. This is a 80mm batch production. So every day we make about 300 of them. 300 of this and 300 of those. So most of it is export, but... So this is the entire motor manufacturing facility that we have, which is currently small. I know we are moving into a much...
Oh, you're still moving?
Yeah, we are going to a facility which is almost 20 times bigger than this.
Wow, okay. That's a motor? That big thing.
These are all our sample motors.
That is huge. What is something like this is for?
This is 150. This gives about 45 kilograms of thrust. With a 47-inch prop.
So there are drones with such huge...
There's a lot of drones in cargo, delivery, even in combat. This is our generator. We make our own generators also. We make our own engines also. So that is our engine for drones.
This is ICE engine?
Yeah, ICE engine. Boxer, two-stroke.
Wow. Wait. This is a motor.
That's a motor. We wind it in a different way so it becomes a starter as well as a generator. First it auto starts, then it becomes a generator.
It's a very nerdy place.
So this is a full combo where there's a motor, ESC, and we also make props obviously. So all of this we sell it as
I've seen on your Twitter that the combined...
Yes, this is the older variant of that.
Okay.
So this is our 80-amp 12S, first revision ESC. It's a fully populated one with all the components.
You have a pick and place?
No, we don't have. We do that outside. So, and there's a, the latest revision of ESC which we are building. It's a FOC based ESC. And there's also a dual stack, tinier version of the same ESC.
Oh, wow. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the same ESC is used here. These are all ESCs. We call it as hexa thrust. So it's a power distribution board and ESCs put together. So there are two different variants of it. This is for hexa, this is for octa. There are 8 ESCs and power distribution, everything built inside, mil certified. So bare bones will look like this prior to assembly. Then we have our best seller. It's a power distribution board where you have the input power comes here and you can connect 4 or 6 motors to it. There is a 12 volts back, 5 volts back, and a power module where you connect it to your flight controller. So similar to this.
What kind of amps this can do?
It can do 400 amps.
400 amps.
This is our latest revision of the same one. Much more upgraded, much more features. We are launching it next month.
400 is insane.
This goes into EFT frames. So where usually this Chinese give something like that, which is actually not safer to use. Mm-hmm. So we replace that in the same footprint. So you take it out, throw it away, put this new power distribution board. It has current sensing, which gives that input to iSense and vSense into your flight controller. Then there is a BEC layer where you get 12 volt and 5 volt. And there's a distribution layer. You can connect all your motors, pumps, or any payloads. Mm-hmm. So it becomes very safer and easier. Mm. And the installation time of the entire drone, assembly time for the manufacturers, drastically comes down. Plug everything and it works. Oh, these are all our internal projects. Okay. So we do a lot of other power distribution boards for export. This one goes into some Canadian drone companies.
Okay. ऐसे फैक्ट्री टूर वीडियोस चाइना के बहुत आते हैं उनके ड्रोन इंडस्ट्री के बारे में भी. नो मैं खुश हूँ कि मैं ऐसे कुछ इंडिया से ला पाया. एंड और भी ज्यादा फैक्ट्री टूर्स आएंगे फ्यूचर में अलग इंडस्ट्रीज के. कुछ लोग ये भी वंडर कर रहे होंगे, जब मैंने वो मेड इन इंडिया ड्रोन वाला वीडियो बनाया जहां मैंने इंडियन कंपोनेंट्स यूज किए मेजॉरिटी, तो वहां पे चाइनीज मोटर्स क्यों, वेक्टर के मोटर्स क्यों नहीं? वो इसलिए क्योंकि वेक्टर का जो रेंज है फिलहाल वो 15 इंच प्रोपेलर साइज प्लस के लिए ही बना रहे हैं मोटर्स. आपने देखे होंगे सब बड़े बड़े थे. और मैंने जो ड्रोन बनाया वो 7 इंच प्रॉप था, ऑल्दो उस पर 10 इंच का सपोर्ट था उस फ्रेम के ऊपर. बट वेक्टर काम कर रहा है एफपीवी क्लास छोटे मोटर्स के ऊपर, और जब भी वो आएंगे आप एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हो मेरे से एक वीडियो. स्पेशल थैंक्स टू जयम शर्मा, वोटले चैतन्य, विशाल भारत, कृपाल पटेल, शौलक पेरनी, कुमार अखिल, चंद्रबदन सिंह, श्रीनाथ कापड़ी, मुनु बाबू, विशेष वत्सल, वॉच न्यू, विद्यासागर रौनकी, वशिष्ठ रेड्डी, प्रवीण वाकोड़े, स्वास्ति देसाई, किट फॉक, वेद हाटोलकर.